When it comes to achieving our wellness goals, our fitness plan should always include body positivity.
And that is the mantra of fitness expert and mindset coach Catherine Tanaka, and she joins us from Toronto. Catherine, nice to see you this morning. Good morning.
Good morning, guys. Nice to see you both.
Okay, listen, we're going to start talking about a common myth, and you say that that is that body positivity and fitness don't always kind of go hand in hand.
Yeah, so what we need to know is that body positivity has become a movement really calling for acceptance of our bodies, regardless of shape, size, color, and ability. So let me break down that myth a little bit for you, Jeff. So the fitness industry is really known for, you know, its diet culture and its weight loss culture. However, tides are really turning, right? The truth is that we can fully embrace body positivity and fitness together at the same time, shifting the focus to how we look, to how we feel, really looking to accept instead of judge, and really hoping that we feel good mind, body, and spirit.
Okay, so explain those ways that fitness supports body positivity.
Yeah, absolutely. So here are three things that I'll share with you, Carolyn. So first, fitness improves our sleep and well-being. Harvard Health really speaks about how daily movement, even just 30 minutes a day, can help us fall asleep faster, spend longer time in deep sleep, and wake up less during the night. And the research is clear that sleep helps improve how we manage our stress. So moving our bodies improves our sleep, and then also improves how we manage stress. So Jeff, I know that you are a big supporter of mental health awareness, and fitness helps our mental health, right? The research is unequivocal that improving our movement helps improve how we manage depression and stress, how we manage our anxiety, and helps us boost that emotional regulation. And especially times like this, as you both know, with the cooler weather coming, those winter blues sometimes creeps up on us. And the research shows that moving our bodies makes us feel better in our bodies. And finally, fitness really improves our self-confidence, right? I've had the privilege of interviewing Dr. Jillian Mandich twice on my podcast, and she, as you guys know, is Canada's happiness doctor, and her research identifies that regular movement really helps boost those feel-good hormones in our bodies.
Okay, so Catherine, knowing all of that, what are some simple things that we can all do to help boost our body positivity?
Yeah, so everyone thinks that fitness needs to look like hard and grueling in the gym, but it actually doesn't have to be that way at all, right? So first thing first, getting outside and walking. We all know since this COVID pandemic that getting outside and getting sunlight boosts our vitamin D, which helps with our immune system. And Carolyn, I know that you love getting outside with your kids, whether it's at the cottage or on the lake. Getting outside and just walking is a really great way to move. And for some of your viewers that maybe have aches and pains or arthritis that really are maybe hesitant to move their bodies, walking is a simple, low impact way that really boosts our well-being. And so I know, Carolyn, that you, your kids water ski like mine. Water skiing is very near and dear to my heart. My kids have been skiing since they were 3 years old. And so they had so much fun on the lake this year. One of the things with fitness is find what is fun, right? Adding fun into fitness is a really great way to move. So think about things like this, Jeff, getting outside in a corn maze or apple picking at times of year like this, right? And doing maybe dance classes with friends, getting together, finding something that is fun will really help boost those feel good hormones.
And you know, my Catherine, final thing. Sorry, I was just going to say, you're so right about that, that fitness doesn't have to be a chore. I mean, many times I'm doing things and my digital device will ask me, are you working out right now? I guess I am. Yeah.
Exactly, Jeff. And you know, one of the things that I know the both of you like to have fun with, and Jeff especially, I know you're a big fan of music, is to find a playlist. Make a playlist that you love, because movement and music is really magical together. Listening to music doesn't only reduce that boredom aspect, but the Journal of Physiology speaks about that it actually improves our stamina during workouts and puts us in a better mood. So these things are super, super important to add in some fun and some movement into our lives.
Catherine knows more about us than we do.
Maybe, I think, yes. So, okay, let's get to work, shall we?
Yes, let's, okay, well, here we have some easy exercise. I know you've said walking, and it's so great, but you have some other exercises that we can do, easy ones that we can do at home?
Yes, absolutely. So I'm going to get you guys moving with me for a second. And one of the things, like we were speaking about with music, is adding in music to something fun. And the both of you don't actually know this, but probably about 10 years ago, I used to be at Chorus Entertainment, where you guys are filming today, doing workouts, doing boot camp classes right there. So I'm going to take you through three easy exercises. So you're going to stand with your feet shoulder width apart, and we're just going to sit into a simple squat. And what I love about this
squat.
Is super... simple squat, totally accessible for everyone to do, right? You can turn and make this fun. Yes. We added in some music, and you don't even need to go deep, right? And then we're going to turn into what I love as a simple skipping rope exercise. Find that imaginary. Yeah, you got it, Jeff. Right? It doesn't have to be big, but you can make it as big and as exciting as you'd like. Okay.
I'm way better at skipping when there's no rope.
I know, but I like it because then we don't need to worry about coordinating and tripping. Amazing. Good. Let's turn it into a side lunge. So you're going to step one.
Let's Are you doing crossovers and you're skipping?
Yeah, good. Step one, let those arms come forward. Yeah, we're going to switch sides. You're going to sit down like you're sitting onto a little stool. Amazing. You guys got it. See, this is nice and easy. So one of the things that I know about you, Jeff, is that during lockdown, you were giving people motivational quotes on your coffee mug, right?
Yes.
And one of the things about moving your body is to celebrate the baby steps. The fact that you're showing up and moving just a little bit today, it's all about practice makes progress, and baby steps count. Really good, guys. Who wants to try a Jaffa cake? Nice and easy.
I don't know. These are baby steps, C-Mac. I can only imagine what a full run would feel
like. I'm
going to
do the dance version.
Like, can it? Fitness can be fun, low impact. We're going to be really great, guys. This is really fun to do with you. So remember, get outside, move your body.
Okay, and a reminder, as we desperately catch our breath here, for more ways to get moving and boost your body positivity, you can visit CatherineTanaka.com/morningshow. Catherine, great to see you this morning and love the message. Thank you.
Thank you so much, guys.